नहीं किया शायद. इन टुडे सेशन वी विल बी लुकिंग एट द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ई प्लेन टी जंक्शन. वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन डिस्कस्ड रिगार्डिंग एच प्लेन टी जंक्शन. वी हैव टू नाउ लुक फॉर द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ई प्लेन टी जंक्शन. And we have to derive the S matrix for this, and we have to analyze based on some equations. We need to see whether this junction acts as a splitter, the power splitter, or not. And then we will be going for the next type of junction, that is EH plane P junction, which is a combination of both. So in the previous session, we have already seen this. The structure, you can see, it is a T shape. The difference between E plane and the H plane is इन एच प्लेन साइड आर्म यहाँ रहेगा. साइड आर्म विल कम हियर एंड दिस इज पैरेलल टू एच फील्ड. दैट्स व्हाई वी कॉल दिस एज एच आर्म. इन केस ऑफ ई प्लेन टी जंक्शन आपका जो साइड आर्म है इट इज ऑन द टॉप वर्टिकल पोजिशन में रहेगा. सो अलोंग द ब्रेड्थ यू कट अलोंग द ब्रेड्थ यू कट द स्लॉट एंड यू अटैच दिस. वी कॉल दिस एज ई आर्म बिकॉज इट इज पैरेलल टू द ई फील्ड. ई फील्ड का लाइन यू कैन सी. And one more important observation we had made in the previous session about the electric field lines. You can see at port 1, vertical direction mein, upwards direction mein hai electric field lines. Looking at port 2, the directions are downwards. What do you mean by this? You can see here also the internal view, upward direction at port 1, downward direction at port 2. There is a phase change occurring when the wave propagates through this E plane T junction. So what is this phase shift? It is the phase shift of 180 degrees. Okay, ye kahan hota hai? You can see during at this point, you know, jahan pe tino lines meet hote hain, at this junction point, reorientation of the field lines takes place. Because of this, the field gets a shift of 180 degrees. So we had started, we have discussed already about the structure. Let us go for its characteristics. Let us list the characteristics. First one, plane of symmetry. Because of the plane of symmetry, the power which is fed into port 3, something like this. Let me simply show you the schematic. Ye port 1 hai. ये पोर्ट 2 है, ये पोर्ट 3 है. सो वट एवर पावर यू फीड एट पोर्ट 3, इट गेट्स इक्वली डिवाइडेड बिटवीन पोर्ट 1 एंड 2 इक्वली. बट देर इज अ फेज शिफ्ट ऑफ 180 डिग्रीज. दैट्स व्हाई अ नेगेटिव साइन विल कम. सो व्हाट विल बी द यस वैल्यू, यस पैरामीटर? इनपुट पोर्ट इज 3, आउटपुट पोर्ट इज 1. सो यस 3-1 इन बिटवीन दीज टू एंड यस 3-2 बिटवीन दीज टू पोर्ट्स. बोथ आर इक्वल बट with a negative sign. So ye wala, this is the first characteristic. Second characteristic, just the same way what we took in case of H plane T junction. Port 3 assumed to be a perfectly matched to the junction. There will be no reflections towards the port 3. So yes, 3-3 will become 0. Perfectly matched to the junction. Junction ko hit karke, no wave will come back to the port 3. Then one more property we are using for S matrix, we have already seen symmetric property. Ij, yes, Ij equals to Sji. This is applicable for a reciprocal network. So using these properties, how we have written the S matrix? S11, S12, S13. Here it is S21, but 21 is equal to 12. Then S22, S23. So actually it is S23. From the symmetric property, what it will be? S32. 23 will be equal to 32. But what is S32 in case of from the first characteristic? Minus S31. Minus S31. Again using the symmetry, minus S13. So it is minus S13. Coming to the third one, S31. Actually, this is S31. Using the symmetry property, S13. Then S32. second term is S32. In the third row, S32, but S32 is equal to minus S31, which is again using symmetry, minus S13. And port 3 is a perfectly matched to the junction, so S33 is equal to 0. Now, what we need to go for? We have to find these unknown values. How many unknown values are there? We have already solved this kind of S-matrix solution, finding the unknowns in case of H-plane T-junction. The similar procedure we will follow it here also. In order to simplify this, we will make use of unitary property. S into S star, the conjugate, complex conjugate of S matrix is equal to identity matrix. S matrix I have written from this. And what is S star? Same entries will be there, but above you have to take star. That is its complex conjugate. Ye first term S11 hai. Yahan par bhi first term S11 hi rahega, but with a complex conjugate, star. Here it is S12, S12 star, S13, S13 star, and so on. For each entries, a star should be put above. Is equal to identity matrix. Now, solving this, you have to take rows and columns multiplication. Identify how many unknowns are there. One, two, three, four. I think four unknowns are there. Actually, from this row and column matrix multiplication and equation, equating, totally you will get 9 equations. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 equations you get. But all those 9 equations we don't require. We require only 4 equations, that too, which will make our work easy. So we will choose the equations wisely. First equation will be first row and first column. If you multiply, you will get this entry equals to 1. Then second row into second column is equal to this. Third row and third column multiplication is equal to 1. So three equations we can get equal to 1, 1, 1. Diagonal elements. One more equation we may require, obviously. So the fourth equation again, how many possibilities are remaining? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Still 6 equations we can get. But out of 6, only one we choose. Which one we can choose depending upon our easiness. The equation which will reduce our work. You can see the third row, it has got a 0 entry. So you take this third row with either first column or second column. You can take these two as 0, 0. As any one equation, you can take the as a fourth equation. So let us solve this. First one, first row into first column. S11, S11 star plus S12 star plus S13, S13 star equals to the first entry, 1. Or if you take simply magnitudes, S11 square, S12 square, S13 square, all together added is equal to 1. Similarly, go for second row, second column. S12, S12 star, S22, S22 star, minus S13, minus S13 star. Ye jo negative sign hai, this is the difference between E plane and H plane T. In earlier H plane T junction, this negative was not there. Here, this negative sign has come. So there is a negative sign, but anyhow, it doesn't matter when we solve this. When we remove this star, we are considering only magnitude. So the negative term will be eliminated. Simply, it is equal to S13 only, even though you have minus S13 and minus S13 star. Again, you are taking the magnitudes. Same. Second equation is same. What is the third equation you get? This row, third row into third column. S13, S13 star plus you have minus S13 and minus, you have a negative sign here, okay? Minus S13 star. Actually, I should have taken minus or plus. I think there comes a negative sign. I have done some mistake here. See, this is a negative sign. So here I have added, I think it is visible to you. But here it should be there. okay, minus into minus plus anyhow. So the third row into third column is equal to 1. So totally 3 equations we got. The fourth equation you can choose any one. I have chosen third row first column. Third row first column. S13, S11 star minus S13, S12 star plus 0. Third term to yahan pe 0 hai. Is equal to 0. Is equal to 0. So this is your fourth equation. So solving this, starting with the first, compare the equation 1 and 2. What you get? Okay, let us solve that later on. Anyhow, we can do it even at the last also. Take the third equation, which we have multiplied. Third row and third column. So we have got this. Taking the magnitudes, S13 square and S13 square, 2 times. So 2 times S13 square, taking only the magnitude, removing the conjugate term, is equal to 1. Or S13 is equal to? So one value we got, S13, which is 1 by root 2. And we have taken the fourth equation as third row and first column, right? Third row and first column, we have got this. I think S13, we can take it common. S13 taking common. S11 star minus S12 star is equal to 0. When this equation is possible, if you have, I had taken the same example earlier also. If this is equal to 0, what do you mean by this? Either A can be 0 or B minus C can be 0. Then only ye equation satisfy hoga. Apply A as 0, 0 into B minus C, 0. Apply this B minus C as 0, 0 into A, 0. Then only this holds good. Similarly, here also you can see S13. This can be 0 or ye jo bracket term hai, that can be 0. But this possibility is not there. Because whenever we are taking port 3, which is the side arm, jab port 3 se aap input feed karte ho, it gets divided between port 1 and 2. So obviously S13 0 nahi hoga. This is discarded. That's why take only this bracket term. This is the second possibility. Or S11 is equal to S12. So this one more supporting equation we got, which will help us. Okay. Now coming to equation 1 and 2. Go for equation 1 and 2. See the terms. RHS may. You have 1, 1. You have S13 at both sides. You have S12 also on both sides. In both the equations. Sorry, not on both sides. In both the equations. Individually in equation 1 and 2. Common terms you can see. So if you equate the equation 1 and 2, S11 square is equal to S22 square or S11 is equal to S22, equating the equation 1 and 2. So one more supporting equation we got. And finally, what we will do, let us take either equation 1 or 2, whichever you want. So you can take that equation, equation 1 I have taken. You can take equation 2 also. What is equation 1? S11 square plus S12 square plus S13 square is equal to 1. But if you see, just now we have got one supporting equation. S11 is equal to S2. So we can substitute that. Instead of S12, we will take S11 only. So 2 times S11 ho jayega. And S13, we have got it as 1 by root 2. So we can find one value here from equation 1. S11 square plus you have S12 here, second term, but we can equate S11 and S12. So I have substituted that plus S13 is 1 by root 2 and this is a square is equal to 1. So 2 times S11 square plus 1 by 2 is equal to 1 or 2 times S11 square is equal to 1 minus half, taking half to the other side, 1 minus half is half. So what is S11 square? 1 by 4, taking this 2 to the other side, 1 by 4, or taking the square root, S11 is half. So, agar S11 aa gaya, so you can get S22 also, and S11 is also related to S12 also. So, I think 4 terms we have found. So, finally, we can write S11 S12, both are same. S13, we have got 1 by root 2. S12 is 1 by 2. S22, S11 and S22, both are same. So again, write half. Then S13, minus S13, which is minus 1 by root 2. S13, minus S13 and 0. So we have got the S matrix for E-plane T-junction. Now, we have to analyze this by making use of the S matrix representation. So let us take this V equals to S into A. This is a three-port device. This junction is a three-port network, port 1, 2, 3, just like H-plane T-junction. So obviously, entries kya honge? B has got B1, B2, B3, three ports, so three reflections. S matrix is having 3x3 matrix. A, the number of incident waves can be A1, A2, A3. If you multiply them, what will be B1 is equal to first row into column. Half into A1 plus half into A2 plus 1 by root 2 into A3. That is your B1. Similarly, go for second, B2. What will be B2 is equal to second row into column. Half into A1 plus half into A2 minus half into 1 by root 2 into A3. That is B2. And what is B3? Third row into column. 1 by root 2 into A1 minus 1 by root 2 into A2 plus 0. So we have got three equations here. From these three equations, now what we will do, we will try to assume some, condition. What is that condition? Consider a case of microwave power being fed into port 3 only. Feeding the power means incident waves, A1, A2, A3, okay, not Bs. Incident waves we are considering, we are feeding the power at third port. So A3 will be active, okay, A3 will be existing, but no power applied at the port 1 and 2. So A1 and A2, again, we are making it zero. So for this particular case, let us see what these equations will be. B1 is equal to, you don't know, will not exist. 1 by root 3, 1 by root 2 into A3. What is B2 is equal to? These two will not come. Minus 1 by root 2, A3. B3, both will not be there. Is 0. So, if you remember, we have taken one of the characteristics of H-plane or E-plane, both, as the port 3 is a perfectly matched to the junction. That is, no reflections coming towards the port 3. So that you can prove here. B3 equals to 0. Reflection with the value reflecting wave is the B3, which is equal to 0. Now, observe the case, the values of B1 and B2. What you can observe? Both values are same. 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2. But you have a negative sign. If you remember, in case of when we were discussing the H-plane T-junction, this was positive. Both were equal in magnitude and they were in phase. That's why, jab aap direction ki baat karte ho, electric field directions, both were upwards only in H-plane T-junction. Both will be in phase. Magnitude and phase mein dono same rehte hain. Both fields, they are in phase. But here you have got one negative sign in case of E-plane T-junction. So what you can conclude with this? We can have this analysis. The input power when we feed at port 3, it divides equally between port 1 and 2. Obviously, values are same, 1 by root 2 A3, 1 by root 2 A3. But there is a phase shift of 180 degrees between them. That's why you have a negative sign here. But in earlier H plane, it was positive. So they were in phase. And one more analysis. No output comes from port 3. That is, no reflections, as it is a perfectly matched to the junction. Okay, this is the analysis. And in terms of powers also, we can analyze this just like the earlier case. How we had taken, you can analyze again. Let me just show you the slide, previous slide, so that you'll remember in terms of powers, and we have calculated the ratios of powers. Yes. Assuming P1, P2, P3 as the outputs, the powers coming out of port 1, 2, 3. So take P3 equals to P1 plus P2, which is 2 times P1 or 2 times P2, taking the ratio, you got minus 3 dB in case of H plane. Similar analysis can be done here also. I have not done that. You can repeat that. You apply the same thing. You repeat the analysis. Consider three different powers. So whatever power you apply at port 3, equally it will be divided between port 1 and 2. And then this port 3 value, it is the sum of the two powers P1 and P2. And both the powers are equal. So P1 is equal to P2 you can take. So I have not written that. But you can do this. And you can see, ये जो B1 and B2 का वैल्यू है मैग्नीट्यूड में दोनों सेम है. ओके, आप मैग्नीट्यूड जब देखते हो 1/√2 times A3, 1/√2 times A3, सो बोथ मैग्नीट्यूड्स आर इक्वल. सो ई प्लेन टी जंक्शन इट ऑल्सो एक्ट्स एज अ 3 डीबी स्प्लिटर. बट व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस हियर? द ओनली डिफरेंस इज देयर इज अ फेज शिफ्ट बिटवीन द आउटपुट्स एट द पोर्ट 1 एंड पोर्ट 2. वो फेज शिफ्ट कितना होगा? 180 डिग्री. आई हैव रिटन इन द ब्रैकेट हियर, फॉलो द एच प्लेन डेरिवेशन इन डेसिबल एंड डिराइव पी इक्वल्स टू माइनस 3 डीबी. ओके, प्लीज रिपीट दैट, यू कैन हैव अ राइट अप. नाउ कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट वन, दिस इज अ कैटेगरी ऑफ वेवगाइड टी जंक्शंस व्हिच इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ बोथ ई प्लेन एंड एच प्लेन. यू कैन सी द स्ट्रक्चर हियर. If I remove this, okay, try to hide this, the remaining structure, let me take a red highlighting line, the remaining structure, it looks like H plane. And if I do the vice versa, I will hide this side arm, I will consider only this. This is your EP. So if you take both together, so that dono ke characteristics aapko milenge, then the junction which is formed, we call it EH plane T junction or hybrid T junction. It is a combination, hybrid T junction. So EH plane is a T-junction is a hybrid junction. It is formed when E and H planes, T-junctions, they are combined as shown. Isko construct kaise karte hain? You can just have a look. We will take one waveguide. We will have one slot here cut along the width. And we will have one cut slot along the breadth. And we will attach the side arms. So this is the EH plane T-junction. So talking about the characteristics, dono ki combination yahan pe milenge. Rectangular slots are cut along both width and breadth, as I said you just now, and the side arms are attached. You can see the numbering, okay? Kyunki when we discussed individually H and E planes T junctions, port 3 were the side arms, right? Dono ke liye. Port 3 we considered as a side arm, jo attach kiya hai. But if you see here, port 1 and port 2, it is constant. Jo collinear arm hai, jo long waveguide hai, wo section hai. Port 3 wala jo section hai, side arm, this is for H arm, H plane. H plane T junction ka port 3 rahega. But if you see above, from the top, so this is your E arm. So E arm ke liye, I have taken port 4. So when we take E and H plane T junctions separately, how many ports will come? Port 1, port 2 and port 3. That's why those T junctions were 3 port devices, because of which 3x3 S matrix we have found. Now you tell me how many ports are here, how many elements will be there in the S matrix, and how many port device this is. As you can see, this is a, that is EH plane T junction. It is a 4-port network, 4-port device hai. That is 4x4 matrix will be there for this particular junction. 4x4 means totally 16 elements will be there. 16 entries will be there in the S matrix. So So the first characteristic what I have listed is the S matrix only. EH plane T junction, it is a four-port junction. Hence, S matrix is of the order 4 cross 4. This is the general matrix I have written, okay? 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 4, 1, 4, 2, 4, 3, 4, 4. Ye ek general matrix maine likha hai. But after listing the characteristics, characteristics kya honge? Hybrid junction ke liye, dono ka combination hoga. Okay, few properties from that and few properties from the other one. If we combine, we will get some characteristics. From those characteristics, we will try to reduce this. Okay, number of jo unknowns hain, let us see how many it is possible. Now, first, let us go for the listing of the characteristics. Now, E plane, let us first see the H plane, because humne H plane pehle discuss kiya hai. So, H plane T junction means, in the figure, I will not consider this. Okay, I'm scratching this, indicating that I'm only now considering the H plane. So, according to the H plane, what was the first characteristics? Because of the plane of symmetry, jo bhi power port 3 mein feed hoga, it gets equally divided between port 1 and 2. So, S31, right? S31, input port is 3, output port is 1. S31 is equal to S32. This was for H junction, H plane T junction, S31 equals to S32. I've written that S31 is equal to S32. Coming to E plane T junction, look at the figure carefully, because port number alag hai yahan pe. It is not 3 now, it is 4. Now I'm scratching this, okay? I'm now looking into only E plane T junction. Check the ports, port 1, port 2 and port 4. So according to the first property, because of the plane of symmetry, if you see cut, if you just cut this symmetrically to exactly 2 halves aayenge aapko. So if you feed the power in port 4, not 3, okay, port 4, it gets equally divided between port 1 and 2, but with a phase shift, okay, it is a H plane T junction. So wahan pe phase shift hota hai 180 degrees. So what is the S value? Input port is 4, output port is 1. So S41 is equal to S42, but you should have a negative sign. Right, one is the negative of the other. So I've written that S42 is equal to minus S41. So ye jo hai first characteristic, dono ka combine karke I have written due to the plane of symmetry. Okay, coming to the next property, we have assumed that jo bhi side arms attached hain, those ports, they are perfectly matched to the junctions. That's why there will be no reflections coming to that port back, right? Junctions ko jab hit karta hai, nothing will come back. We have assumed this. So for port 3, it was S33 is equal to 0. But yahan pe aur ek side arm hai, port 4, it is also S44 is equal to 0. So when we assume that port 3 and port 4 are perfectly matched to the junction, S33 and S44 will be equal to 0. This is the second characteristic. Fine. Now the third characteristic, I think we had used symmetric property. So from symmetry property, Sij equals to Sji. And this is one additional property. Okay. Let me read it out first. Because of the geometry of the junction, jis tarah se humne connect kiya hai, you know, four different ports are joined together, the microwave signal which is fed into port 3, it cannot induce a signal in port 4 and vice versa. What do you mean by this? Let me show you the structure, you'll understand it. So we have connected them in such a way that if I feed the power here in port 3, this gets equally divided between port 1 and 2, right? But nothing is going to port 4. Remember, jo port 3 se enter hota hai, it will split among port 1 and 2, but not to port 4. Port 4 ko enter nahi hoga. Similarly, consider the second case. जहां पे यू अप्लाई द पावर हियर, व्हेन यू फीड द पावर एट पोर्ट 4, इट गेट्स इक्वली डिवाइडेड बिटवीन पोर्ट 1 एंड 2 अगेन, बट एक फेज शिफ्ट होता है 180 डिग्री फेज शिफ्ट, बट नथिंग इज कमिंग इन पोर्ट 3. जब पोर्ट 3 से एंटर होता है इट इज नॉट एंटरिंग पोर्ट 4, जब पोर्ट 4 से एंटर हो रहा है इट इज नॉट एंटरिंग पोर्ट 3. ओके, दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ द दिस कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. बिकॉज ऑफ द ज्योमेट्री द सिग्नल विच इज फेड इन टू पोर्ट 3 विल नॉट इंड्यूस एनी सिग्नल इन पोर्ट 4 और द रिवर्स. जब आप पोर्ट 4 में एंटर करते हो पावर पोर्ट 3 को नहीं जाता है. बिकॉज ऑफ दिस पोर्ट 3 एंड 4 वी कॉल देम आइसोलेटेड पोर्ट्स. एक से दूसरे कोई ना बनती नहीं है. When you enter, when you feed a power in one port, it will not come out of the other port. This is called these pair, port 3 and 4, we call it isolated ports. This property, this characteristic is very important because when we find finally at the end, the S matrix jab hum find karenge, we have to analyze the values. There this property is very important. Okay, so now remember port 3 and 4, they are isolated ports. So isolated means what? Jo port 3 ko aap power feed kar rahe ho, it is not coming out of power 4. That is, it is not coming out from port 4. Sorry. So it is yes 3-4, or if you are taking the power at port 4, if you are feeding, it is not coming at power port 3. So yes 3-4 or yes 4-3, both are 0. There is no power. There is no, you know, connection nahi hai dono ke beech mein. So which is equal to 0. So we have done some listing of the characteristics. I think now we can write the S matrix. S11, S12, S13, S14 as it is. Next, S21. S21 is equal to S12, symmetric property. Then S22 as it is. This is S23. What is S23? S23 is equal to S32. But what is S32? S32 is equal to S31. Again, applying the symmetry property, it is S13. Fine, that's why it is S13. And this fourth value is S24. So what is S24? Using the symmetry property, it is S42. Look at the first characteristic. What is S42? It is minus S41. It is minus S41. Use the symmetry property, minus S14. So I have written that. Then S31. So first entry kya hoga? S31 hai. You can see here. So it is S31, third entry, third row. S31 is 1-3, symmetry. Then S32. S32 is equal to S13. Then S33. What is S33? Port 3 is perfectly matched. S33 is 0. What is S34? S34 is also 0. So, ye dono entries 0 ho gaye. Then S41. 41 is equal to 1-4. Symmetry property. S42. What is S42? S42 is minus S41, which is equal to minus S14. S43. S43 is 0. S43 is 0. Isolated ports. And S44. Perfectly matched junction. S44 is 0. So if you observe the matrix, 4 entries we have got 0. Okay. How many unknowns are there here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 unknowns are there. It is easy. 5 unknowns hai. I require minimum 5 equations to solve this. Using the unitary property, again what I'll do, S into S star, the conjugate is equal to identity matrix. I will take this S matrix, which I have found just now. Then I will take its conjugate, write the entries as it is, put a star, that's it, is equal to this. Now, four equations I can get directly, diagonal elements. First row, first column, one equation. Second row, second column, one equation. Third row, third column, one equation. Fourth row, four column, one more equation. Four equations directly. I require one more equation. One more equation, it is up to you which one you want to choose. Easier would be take either this or this. Kyunki yahan pe entries kam hai. Okay, you can take anyone with these rows. Further, please try to solve these, this matrix.